give the rein a little bit. When you have them so collected and so supple, then show a moment, you know what, I can release the inner rein a little bit. Really show and prove to yourself when your horse is more engaged that we can match this with an equal amount of suppleness. There you go. I don't mind what you did there with your hands. Perfectly fine. Good. Walk pirouette, and then we change a little bit in the walk pirouette, we change up the flexion a little bit so that he gets a little bit more elastic looking in the top line. I love what he does with the hind leg, yeah, but I want you to have more tools to make the neck and the top line look more elastic, yeah. So walk pirouette and switch up the bend a little bit, going sometimes from inside flexion to outside flexion. So, excellent, good. Not that much, just a little bit. So, that it shows me again, he is supple, he is elastic. Show it, Anita, yeah? And praise him. So, this is beautiful. The horse should go into the bridle, no doubt, but never accept if it's too much. That's nice. Good job, same thing to the right. And what you did there in the walk pirouette, do the same thing in the canter pirouette. Once in a while, straighten the neck, barely flex them a little bit outside, and then flex them back to the inside in a large schooling pirouette, okay? Clearly shoulders leading. I love how easily he goes sideways, but when a horse goes too much sideways and falls against the inner leg, we can't get the cadence, yeah? Good, I add a little cadence to it. Go less sideways. I know that's working. He's beautiful crossing, Anita. What I don't know, if he can do eventually a half pass that lives somewhere between a medium trot and a passage. That's when we get a 9, yeah? And you need to head here and there for a few steps into that direction, okay? Tapping into this area. Good. Less sideways, more cadence. Less sideways. From the inner leg, stop the sideways motion. Stop the sideways motion. Yes, and that's what I mean. Do you know what I mean? Good. So, and walk him a second. Excellent, that's good. Anita, what I'm looking for there, I love his commitment of crossing so beautifully sideways. That's awesome. But you need to teach him, when you touch him with the inner leg, we go a moment straight ahead, and this happens. He comes off the ground. Yeah? The more he goes sideways, the more balance it takes, the harder it is to create more lift and cadence in the half pass. You follow me? Usually we have the opposite problem. A horse doesn't want to go enough sideways. That's not the problem. He's beautiful to your outside leg. I love that. But if the sideways motion takes away from the cadence, the swinging off the back, then we stop briefly the lateral movement and we say, here, a bit more trot, and then we go sideways again. Yeah?